Hi, everybody.
Hello.
Hi, what's up, Raffy? What's up, man?
Good. I know we're going through a rough patch right now, but it's still nice to connect virtually with people. And so congrats again on this.
Fast. Yeah, thank you. I'm glad we get to do this, man.
Thank you. So my first question is for Darren. With Versace and now with Hollywood, you and Ryan Murphy have been bringing a lot of Filipino representation in mainstream TV, which is the most I've seen in recent years. And I'm Filipino. Can you talk a little bit about what it was like to bring, I guess, much needed Asian representation to the show with your character and also Raymond, and also with anime, her storyline?
Sure. Sure. Yeah. I mean, in the past, it's odd because my whole life I've had to learn a lot of these terms I've never been familiar with. It's a work in progress figuring out what the cultural language is, where it is most effective and appropriate. So I've learned the term in the past few years, white passing or being passing at all, which is not something I ever thought about ever in my entire life. In my mind, I was Filipino. My dad was white. That was it. And I never thought about it. And then you start realizing that people like having the right language to identify things so they feel properly represented. And that was something that, was a predominant thing in the Versace story simply because he didn't look like a certain archetype of being Filipino, whatever that means. In this case, and I think the character's unwillingness to cop to that was from his own fear and his own prejudice. Whereas I think that restraint in this context has to do more with the fear of being treated like the other, especially when, his white passingness is giving him access to have certain opportunities. It's something that I think he has a chip on his shoulder for. Now, obviously, we can't compile all of the Asian experience into one thing. It's like all cultural experiences, they're infinitely varied. But I think Raymond, because he does have an Asian American or Asian heritage, he takes this as sort of his own personal crusade to use this white passing access card as a means to battering ram the door down and fight this kind of social justice fight for other Asian Americans or people that have been historically marginalized. And he kind of centralizes this around Anna Mae Wong, who, while Raymond is a fictional character, Anna is a very real person, and her tragic tale is very real and very tragic. I said tragic twice. That's how you know how tragic it is. His MO is not too dissimilar from that of Ryan Murphy's, who uses film as a way to push culture forward in a direction that is, more representative of what the world looks like. And he's always looking out for the underdog and the people whose stories have not been able to be told, which is just like Raymond. So there's kind of a similarity there. And I think he's always been interested in the fact that I was half Filipino. So he really wanted to include that in some way to give it some more, immediacy, maybe to me, but for anybody out there that may feel like, that they have to hide some part about them in order to have access to things. That's an unfortunate struggle. And ultimately, we watch Raymond come to terms with that, but I think, Raymond's a very small piece of this puzzle that all the characters, and I'll pass this off to the girls, everybody kind of comes in with their own sense of being held back by something, by the society around them, whether it's your queerness or your gender or your age or your financial situation. There's a lot of things that put up walls to people that were particularly dictating of the 1940s. So, he's just a small version of that, of someone who's biracial and, the point is everybody wants to push the needle forward, and everybody's adding to that push in a very different way throughout this entire show.
Well, I'll tell you something, Archie. I'm going to change the way they make movies in this town. I'm going to make sure that people like us aren't on the outside looking in anymore.
What do you mean, people like us?
Folks who aren't white.
You ain't white?
Asian. Half.
You shitting me.
Huh? My whole life I feel like I've been living in a really convincing costume.
Yeah. But you could pass. That ain't like being black.
You sound like my girlfriend.
Hold up. You dating a sister? Well, it's gotta be tough though. Can't go out together.
Yeah, some places they don't mind. The world's changing.
Maybe, but it ain't changing fast. So, Dick Samuels, you think he knows?
Knows what?
That I'm black.
He doesn't already know?
I never met anybody in person. I mailed in my script. He called me on the telephone. And I told him, golly, Mr. Samuels, I'm just over the moon. You like my script.
You did not.
Golly, Mr. Samuels.
I did. Well, I hate to break it to you, Buster, but I'm pretty sure he's going to find out pretty soon.
And Laura, Camille had a lot of starting moments in the series, and she was actually recognized by the industry for her hard work in the end. So what was that like to play her, especially since in real life, so many actresses of color to this day still don't get the recognition they deserve from their peers in the world?
I mean, I was really honored to be able to play Camille, not just to be part of the show, but to be a piece of telling the stories of, I think, you know, so many women of color throughout the years who have been marginalized and haven't been able to reach the success that they deserve or haven't been recognized for their achievements due to, you know, being a person of color. And that kind of goes for, I think, everyone in the story, be it, you know, women or the LGBTQ community or people of color. It's really about telling everyone's stories and acknowledging everyone. So I just kind of, you know, look to people like Dorothy Dandridge and Lena Horne, who were at the forefront of their industry at that time, who were the first Black women who were able to be leading ladies. And then think about, you know, it's really cool that then I'm able to be here because of people like them. And they didn't have people to look up to watching movies growing up that looked like them. They didn't see themselves, and to have the bravery to want to push forward and do that when it's never been done before. It was super inspiring. So I just wanted to pay homage to all of those women who came before me.
Yay. And I'm getting the rap signal. So thank you again all for the time. Sorry.
Thank you.
No worries. I talk a lot. Sorry, Rev.
It's okay. Thank you again.
Take care. Bye. Bye.